G'day guys, back again. Hope you're doing well. Now guys, forgive me for this and don't have a heart attack. I know I normally do figures and sci-fi and pretty much and obviously armor as well. I think I haven't done too many armor videos lately, and actually I haven't done many figures lately. So my figure guys out there, hang in there. I've got a couple of figures that I'm going to review pretty shortly and one or two armor pieces that I've picked up as well. But now, I don't think this could be my first one, but guys, this Tamir kit. Now, there's a couple of reasons why I haven't done many car videos. One is I just like certain cars, guys. I don't really know much about them. I just like the look of them. I like sci-fi stuff. I think, geez, I like that. And I want to buy it. There's a couple of reasons why I really like this kit. A, this to me, and guys, if you're car guys, please don't have a tanty at me about this, but for me, apart from, oh, what was the really early sleeker? The little two-door, all sleekers, that might sound funny, are they all two-door sleekers, silly cars? The first, is it the LTD, is it? The first two-door sleeker, or not, it probably wasn't the first one, anyway, it was probably in the 70s or something like that. Maybe, yeah, it would have been in the 70s, I think, the little two-door, absolutely loved that sleeker when it came out. And other than that, the sort of flat, squarey type one I didn't really like. But then this one came out, not with obviously all the rally lights on and everything like that. This is just, you know, the manufacturer one that people could buy, the civil one, if you want to call it that. And I absolutely loved it. And one of my mates at school, because I'm pretty young, his father had it. And he had in red, and I just absolutely loved it. You know when you're a bit younger and you see something and you think, when I grow up, I'm going to buy that? Well, that never happened to me. I never bought one of these, but I absolutely love this. And probably as far as things go, this is probably my favourite sleeker, obviously without the lights and everything on it, car that you could buy. Really love the design of it. Rarely see one on the roads now around here. Probably once, maybe a year, I might see one around the roads, but I still absolutely love the design or the shape of this car. Hence, I wanted to pick this up. And the other thing is, I absolutely missed out on, if you watch my channel, I do like a bit of remote control RC stuff. And I think I was out of the RC hobby when this came out. Tamir brought this out, I think, as a radio control version. Guys, I couldn't tell you what chassis was on. I could make something up. Was it a TT something? Or I can't remember now, but it probably wasn't the best chassis, as in for, you know, off-roading. I'm getting a bit off track here. Off-roading for RC. But, you know, I absolutely love the shape of this. So much so, even though the car wasn't around for a couple of years, I actually bought the shell with all the stickers in the hope that I would actually get the Tamir RC version. And then I sold the shell. And then about a year ago, I found the whole Tamir RC kit of this for sale in a shop. But the guy was wanting something like, you know, I think it was around $400-$500 for it, because it's kind of vintage now. And I just didn't want to pay that for it, because in some of the older RC cars, the plastic gets a bit brittle. And, you know, and obviously if you can't get parts for it, if you drive it around, you know, it breaks, well, then it's kind of like pointless. So anyway, a bit off on tangent there, guys. But the reason why I don't do reviews of cars, because, you know, I just like the look of them. I don't really get into the whole nitty-gritty of all this sort of stuff, blah, 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 blah. But I'm happy to show you the instructions. And probably the other thing that I didn't really like about this kit is, and it's a bit of a beef of mine, when you show little figures, you know, like this, in the driver and passenger seat, I kind of think you should add them in the kit to me. I mean, you did that for your WRX kit, which is another kit I like, which I'll probably do a little video on. So you added them in your WRX kit, but you didn't add them in this one, which I was a little bit cranky about. Let's have a look inside. Now, if you're just starting out, it's pretty easy. This is all in white anyway. So that's a pretty easy starting point. If you just want to put the decals on, you almost don't even have to paint it. But, and I forgot to mention this about this model, or sorry, this actual car. I am a sucker pop-up lights. I know it sounds pretty lame, But I just love the pop-up lights. Now, guys, many years ago, I had an RX-7 Series 2. That's right. I was cool once. Well, some people probably laugh at me and think RX-7s weren't cool, but I think they're cool. And I had RX-7 Series 2 pop-up lights, and I absolutely loved that thing. Absolutely fantastic car. And shame that they changed the not doing too many RX-7s anymore. You know, and obviously people have their little reasons for that, but I absolutely loved it. And hence the reason why I probably like this car as well, because it's got pop-up lights. I'm not a huge car guys. Now, this is boggling to me, but it won't be two car guys. These are actually slick tyres. Now, I would have thought on a rally car, you would have got off-road tyres, but, you know, call me strange. Call me crazy. I would have thought that, but you know, guys, as I said, I'm not a huge car guy. Maybe this is on tarmac or cement. I kind of thought this was off-road, but I'm showing my car skills here in a big way, guys. So I apologize for that. Something that always baffled me about these Tamiya, well, not these car kits, but the Tamiya tank kits. I mean, in here, they'll give you lights, clear lights, for the headlights on these car kits, but you know, on a tank kit where you get one clear light or two, to me for a long time has just made you giving you the solid plastic bits. So it kind of baffles me in a way. As I said, guys, I'm not going to go all through this. I'm just giving you a bit of an insight to my crazy hobby likes, and this car is definitely one of them. There is definitely no figures in this kit at all. Nice little interior there. And you get the whole roll cage and all that. And you do get different types of rims there by the looks of it. That must have been, I'm guessing, for the... I don't know. Did they do an off-road version of this car? But I tell you what, compared to a tank kit, this looks, you know, apart from the paint job, because I always get a bit scared with painting cars, because I think it's a, you know, you can mess up a tank pretty easily and fix it up, but cars, oh, not so much. But, yeah, bit of disappointment that you don't get figures in this. That's probably my only beef about this kit, as far as I know, until I actually make it. And, as I said, I would have liked off-road wheels. Which I was expecting, so silly me, I was going to do this on dirt, so that's going to maybe not take place, unless I put so much mud. No, I don't think that's going to work. As you know, I like to show the instructions, so we'll do that quickly. I'm not going to go through all the kit, I'm not going to do a Flory Models and tell you every bit on the kit. We're just going to go through step by step, and you guys can have a look. I've got to say it, all this stuff, and car guys, I apologize, but all this sort of stuff, to me, this is the boring part of building the kit. I kind of, you know, when you get really, well, this isn't intricate, but lots and lots of parts to things you're not going to see, it sort of doesn't really excite me. I like the stuff you're going to see. And I think the roll cage inside's pretty cool, and all those parts. And I just kind of don't want you need to give you any figures. Very slack to me, very slack. I'm pretty sure, well, I can modify the WRX guys to fit in here, and I'm sure there's a couple of other kits that have figures in it. If I go through, you know, the old Tamiya catalogs? That was one good thing about those old Tamiya catalogs, which I have shown one or two on my channel, is you used to have, I don't know if you remember, you used to have all the car pictures of the models made up, and you could look at the cars and go, oh yeah, that one's got figures in it. And I know it sounds crazy, but I do love figures, guys. You know, oh yeah, that's got figures in it. And I'd go along and go, oh no, that one hasn't got figures in it. And I'd go through the catalog and look at all these ones, same with sort of other things as well. Some like the motorbikes as well, you know, every now and again. I think I did, what did I do? Oh God. Was it a T-Max scooter that I just did recently with a figure on it? I bought that Tamiya kit because it had a figure on it. But some of the other motorbikes I look at, and in that catalogue, yeah, look, and if it had a figure with the motorbike, I was so much more likely to buy it, which is going to get up to probably my next video, which I've got to show you, which is a motorbike, surprisingly enough. Tamiya again, because I actually do love the Tamiya brand. Have I skipped something here, guys? No. So you do get the buckles and everything like that, seat belts, all that sort of stuff. It's nice that you get the decals. I probably wasn't expecting that, as I don't do many car kits. It is nice how you can do a bit of a sub-assembly, because like I said, I don't do many cars, and actually paint stuff up before you actually slap it all in place. And because I'm not a really big decal fan, I'm really not sure if I'd put all the decals on this. I was just, as I said in a lot of my videos, probably not white, but I was thinking about just painting this whole thing a different colour, like I did with my Tamiya T-Max, and choose a colour I like, and just weather the whole thing up as a civilian type vehicle, not a rally vehicle. And I wasn't even thinking about, which I'm still umming and ahhing about, apologies, was whether I'd put these lights on it or not. I wasn't sure if I was going to do that or not, because I actually really liked the version that came out that you could buy without a lot the little headlights on it here. So I'm not too sure about that. But if I was to do something in mud, I'd love to, and because they've got the clear headlights, I'd love to flick mud all over those and just sort of, you know, really mess it up. If someone's out there watching this video, anyone that knows much about Tamiya cars, can you buy some rally tires for this somewhere or from another kit? I mean, I probably could take them off another kit, but I don't really want to do that. Is there a way or a company that sells tires and wheels that I could swap over that is a direct sort of fit on these sort of kits? I'd be curious to know that. Jeez, I tell you what, could they add a couple more decals? I mean, look at this. Look at the amount of decals on this. Holy dooly, that is unbelievable. That is crazy. It actually made me think just for a second, I have no idea why, but imagine if you did a Mac kit, FS3D kit, with these sort of decals on it, with all the other little smaller decals on it. How cool would that be? Very strange, but very cool. Anyway, guys, this is one of the cars that I've loved ever since I was a young person. Child. No, maybe not a child, teenager. And I'll just show you the sides of the box. I don't know, the colours here, even though they're very strange colours with the green and the red and the white, sort of like a strange combination, but absolutely love the look of this car. And I do like the colours on it. I just don't know if I could be bothered putting all those decals all over it. And even from the top here, looks very nicely done. And guys, I mean, come on. I mean, look, I've got pretty weird taste in cars, or a diverse taste in cars. I love Corvettes. You know, the older Corvettes, the Stingray. I was never into Transams. I love this look of this car. I love Lamborghinis. But then I love Jeeps. I love a CJ7. Absolutely love a CJ7. I had a Jeep Wrangler. What was it? A TJ around 2004 model Jeep Wrangler. Loved it. But anyway, guys, that was a strange journey into one of the cars that I love, and a Tamiya model that I love. Except for not getting the figures, which makes me a bit cranky. Thanks a lot for watching, guys, and I'll catch you later.